and wasat. يعني wasat, what is the right? One of them, قال أوسطهم. One of them said, told them, please don't do this. Because why? Because do what your father did. Otherwise, if you take this money and then you spend it on your health, you take this money and you spend it on bad things. No, Allah gave you so much blessings in this money. The little money you have, keep that legacy of your father, because Allah will protect you by that. I said, no, and you have to be one of us. Either you are with me or against me. Right? So either with me. You have to be with me. So they slept that night, the night of the meeting. Still, their father just got buried. They slept that night with the intention, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّةِ وَإِنَّمَا لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مَا نَوَى. They slept with the intention. And tomorrow morning, they made a deal. Tomorrow morning, first thing, after the moon disappears, they're going to go to their farms, because that's the time, what, to take the fruits. Before what? Before any of the poor people show up. This is the deal. Everybody agreed. Slept that night. And during the night, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent what? Because of this niyyah. Now look, we're going back to the hadith of the niyyah, right? We said one time before that an action, you do one action and you may affect the world around you. One action. Right, you say astaghfirullah, you change everything around you. Now, these people didn't say anything. They had niyyah to do something. They haven't woken up yet. They just slept to do it tomorrow. Look at this. This is in Surah Al-Qalam, the Quran. Go back to Surah Al-Qalam tonight, inshallah, and review it. فَأَصْبَحُوا, they woke up, said, let's go. Time now to go and get all that food, not give it to anybody. إِنَّ بَلَغْنَاهُمْ كَمَا بَلَغْنَا أَصْحَابَ الْجَنَّةِ إِذْ أَقْسَمُوا لَيَصْرِمُنَّهَا مُصْبِحِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Qalam, those of the people of Jannah. Jannah means what? Jannah means farm. Jannah means farm from Jannah, or Jannah shay'a ikhtafa. In the Arabic language, when you say Jannah, it means something that disappeared, that does not show. That's why you say jinn. Why is it jinn? Because you can't see them. طوالي, what does jinn have to do? أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Jinn have to do with Jannah? Because in Jannah, in a farm, in a very good farm, what are you supposed to have? You're supposed to have trees right next to each other. In a very dense place, right? Trees after trees after trees. And these trees, the branches of the trees, they are within each other, like that, And that's why, and there are rivers actually between them. جَنَّةَ كَنْ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ. That is Jannah. And because it is Jannah, why? Because you can't see the fruits. Why? Because there's so many trees and so many green around it, of so much things. خَيْرَةً. That's one of the interpretations. But anyway, إِدْأَقْسَمُوا. They swore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the ayah, the meaning of the ayah, they made a promise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَيَسْرُمُنَّهَا, what does it mean? That means, لَيَحْصُدُنَّهَا, لَيَقْطَعُنَّهَا. That means they will take all the fruits in the morning, first thing in the morning. وَلَا يَسْتَثْنُونَ. Not only that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the ayah after this, and they will make no exceptions. It means what? It doesn't matter if they're going to have poor people, if they're going to have an orphan coming, if they're going to have a widow that doesn't have any place or anything to eat, if they have a family that can't even find water to drink, they will make absolutely no exception. وَلَا يَسْتَثْنُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this is the telling us what they did. This is the no more exceptions. خلاص. It's over. Our father has been generous for a very long time. And they slept. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during the night ordered a storm. A storm. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows the soldiers. This storm ordered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what did it do to these farms and their lands? It destroyed them with fire and everything. فَأَصْبَحَتْ كَالصَّرِيمِ. What does sareem mean? Like the black coal. You know, if you burn something very black, and turns very, very black. This is how dark it is. It means not only it burned the trees and it burned the fruits, it burned the land, so the land turned so black from fire. It burned the water, that the water was so burned. It burned even the places around the whole place. It's unbelievable. Changed the whole thing. Everything is burned. So next day, they woke up in the morning. So they woke up and they said, let's go. And they are making etachafatun, means they're talking, whispering. Etachafatun is whispering. Those brothers, miskin. Today, from today on, no more masakin, but they are whispering, so what? So the poor people up there are living on the sides or saying anything, they can't hear them. They can't hear because they went very early in the morning. When they reached the place, the address, they looked. Inna la balloon. Shock. What does balloon mean? Khan has two meanings here. Balloon, that means, yes, we have, now they figured. We have disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look what Allah did us. Or balloon, we are misguided. What is misguided? Dal an tariq. That means we are mistaken. This is not our land. We must have gone to the wrong address. This is a disbelief in the whole thing. It's like someone who wants to come to North Cross, and then he goes to Lawrenceville. How about dal, for example, dal tariq? Okay, that's what I mean. But Gada, he came to the address of the Jannah, of the land, and he said, I must be dal, no balloon. I lost my way. I missed my way. I should have gone the other way. No. And then their middle brother, what did he say? He said, haven't I told you to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and glorify Him? Come from the end of stuff. الحمد لله أن كثيرا كما قال الله لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له والغامض من جهد به وكفى وأشهد أن سيدنا مولانا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم خاتم الأنبياء المحضر صلى الله وسلم وبارك على هذا النبي الأمي وعلى آله أهل الفقه والنظر والعلم والأثر وعلى من بآثاره اختفى واشتكى. Dear brothers and sisters, it's very important that we watch our niyyah, not only our actions. We were talking about our deeds and our actions before, a few weeks ago. And we said how we have to put a monitoring system to monitor our actions. Now we have to go a little bit step further than that and monitor our niyyah. Because this niyyah that these people didn't do anything yet. They haven't gone to the land to take the fruits yet. They only made this intention and slept overnight, and Allah destroyed everything they have because of that. كذلك العذاب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the ayah after that, كذلك العذاب. ولعذاب الآخرة أكبر. But not only that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, but the adab, the punishment of the akhirah is much worse than that. If they know. But they don't know. Therefore, please exercise as much as we can, all of us, and because we all are sinners. Exercise this monitoring system about our niyyahs. If we have bad niyyah, if we maybe intended something wrong, to say, you know, astaghfirullah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of you. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وآل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين وأعلي يا مولانا كلمة الحق والدين. اللهم من أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين خيرا فوفقه إليه، ومن أراد بهم غير ذلك فاجعل دائرة السوء عليه. اللهم رد المسلمين إلى دينك ردا جميلا. اللهم رد المسلمين إلى دينك ردا جميلا. اللهم رد المسلمين إلى دينك ردا جميلا. اللهم آت أنفسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا بأمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. يا نعم المولى ويا نعم النصير، غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير. اللهم اشف مرضانا وعاف مبتلانا وفك أسرانا وارحم موتانا، وصلى الله وسلم.